closing the breach is our primary goal. But I hope we might also discover what was used to create it. Any artifact of such power is dangerous. The destruction of the Conclave proves that much.
You don't think whatever created the explosion was destroyed in the blast?
You survived, did you not? The artifact that created the breach is unlike anything seen in this age. I will not believe it destroyed until I see the shattered fragments with my own eyes.
We would do well to try to recover whatever created the breach.
Liliana's people have scoured the area near the blast and found nothing. Whatever the artifact was, it is no longer there. In any case, did you need me for anything?
I'd like to know more about you, Solas.
Why?
You're an apostate, yet you risked your freedom to help the Inquisition.
Not the wisest course of action when framed that way.
I appreciate the work you're doing, Solas. I just wanted to know more about you.
I'm sorry. With so much fear in the air, what would you know of me?
What made you start studying the Fade?
I grew up in a village to the north. There was little to interest a young man, especially one gifted with magic. But as I slept, spirits of the Fade showed me glimpses of wonders I had never imagined. Treasured my dreams. Being awake, out of the Fade, became troublesome.
Its spirits try to tempt you.
No more than a brightly colored fruit is deliberately tempting you to eat it. I learned how to defend myself from more aggressive spirits and how to interact safely with the rest. I learned how to control my dreams with full consciousness. There was so much I wanted to explore.
I gather you didn't spend your entire life dreaming.
No. Eventually, I was unable to find new areas in the Fade.
Why?
Two reasons. First, the Fade reflects the world around it. Unless I traveled, I would never find anything new. Second, the Fade reflects and is limited by our imaginations. To find interesting areas, one must be interesting.
Is this why you joined the Inquisition?
I joined the Inquisition because we were all in terrible danger. If our enemies destroy the world, I would have nowhere to lay my head while dreaming of the Fade.
I wish you luck.
Thank you. In truth, I've enjoyed experiencing more of life to find more of the Fade.
How so?
You strengthen your body to deliver and withstand punishment. The muscles are an enjoyable side benefit. You have chosen a path whose steps you do not dislike because it leads to a destination you enjoy. As have I.
You said you traveled to many different places.
This world, or its memory, is reflected in the Fade. Dream in ancient ruins, and you may see a city lost to history. Some of my fondest memories were found in crumbling cities. Long picked dry by treasure seekers, the best of the battlefields. Spirits press so tightly on the veil that you can slip across with but a thought.
Any place in particular?
I dreamt of Ostagar. I witnessed the brutality of the Darkspawn and the valor of the Ferelden warriors. I saw Alistair and the hero Ferelden light the signaled fire, and Loghain's infamous betrayal of Caelan's forces.
I've heard the stories. It would be interesting to hear what it was really like.
That's just it. In the Fade, I see reflections created by spirits who react to the emotions of the warriors. One moment, I see heroic wardens lighting the fire and a power-mad villain sneering as he lets King Caelan fall. The next, I see an army overwhelmed and a veteran commander refusing to let more soldiers die in a lost cause.
You can't tell which is real.
It is the Fade. They are all real.
Have you always traveled and studied alone?
Not at all. I have built many lasting friendships. Spirits of wisdom, possessed of ancient knowledge, happy to share what they had seen. Spirits of purpose helped me search, Even wisps, curious and playful, would point out treasures I might have missed.
I don't know of any spirits by those names.
They rarely seek this world. When they do, their natures do not often survive exposure to the people they encounter. Wisdom and purpose are too easily twisted to pride and desire.
I'm impressed that you could become friends with spirits.
Anyone who can dream has the potential. Few ever try. My friends comforted me in grief and shared my joy. Yet, because they exist without form, as we understand it, the Chantry declares that spirits are not truly people. Is Cassandra defined by her cheekbones and not her faith? Varric by his chest hair and not his wit?
I hadn't thought about it that way, but I see your point.
I thank you. Few are willing to entertain such a notion.
We'll talk later.
Goodbye.